Alex didn't even hesitate, because I sat there for a minute, not knowing what was going on, and he pulled me down, and he covered my head, and he said, shh, stay down, it's okay, shh, stay down. So I did. He didn't do anything for me, and he always told me that, too. I wish I could have protected him the same way he protected me. I've been telling people he was my angel that night, but he was my angel every day I knew him, from the day I met him. He didn't do anything for me, and he always told me that, too. I wish I could have protected him the same way he protected me.
Supposed to be having a good time.
We were just supposed to watch a movie.
Why did you feel the need to go to court?
That's what he would have done for me. He had courage. He would have stood up. I was going to stand up for him. You killed my son. You killed the best man on earth. It's his loss, too.
What would you say is the predominant emotion? Is it sadness? Are you angry?
I'm broken. I'm all of those things.
And I know now more than ever that there is a God because of Alex. Because Alex is still coming through. Because that's the kind of man he is. That's the kind of goodness that was in him.
I could see you leaving the theater, but like really, the theater was empty. It felt like so. That's when I got out, and yeah, I kept thinking that. It was like, oh my gosh, I think John just took a bullet for me. I was thinking about what a great hero he is. And like, he provided me the opportunity to survive through that. And he just knew, you know.
He was obviously a wonderful person. And what he did for you in those final moments. What would you want people to know about this man that you loved?
He was just a hero last night. He has been a hero, you know, forever, and well before I even met him. One thing he said to me once was, we were like talking, and one thing he said was, Jensen, I was born to serve my country. And because he was re-enlisting, and it was just what he wanted to do, and he loved it, you know? And I know, even though, like, he saved me and he gave me the opportunity to live, he would have done it for anyone that day. You know, the nearest person sitting next to him, he would have been like, this person needs my help now. And that's just who he was, and everybody knew it. He went above and beyond to help everyone, and he was an incredible person.
In another part of the theater, another man with the same instinct, John Larimer, a Navy man who jumped over his seat to cover up his girlfriend, Julia. Appearing on Fox News, she told her side of it.
He just ducked over and held my head tight and put his body in front of mine, and in the process of doing so, he actually got shot.
Matthew McQuinn died trying to provide cover for his girlfriend, Samantha Yowler. His stepfather, David Jackson, says he's proud of McQuinn's actions.
And it's not surprising to me that his first thought would be her. Yeah, that's what a man does. He protects his loved ones. And I'm very proud of him. I'm gonna miss him.